You are very pretty with dress on. Thank you. Hello again. Ablen Mao Hei. Hello. One dance. Daniel Emiliano Herrera de la Cruz. Teta. Hi, Teto. Hello. Good morning. Can you dance? You can dance. Having a fun on the line. Oh, see that girl. Watch the scene, digging the dancing queen. You want to see my belly? My belly fats.
He told MoFan that the winner of his duel would be trained in the sacred spring, which was a powerful spring of magical water that harnesses a magician's abilities, but was beginning to vanish. He said that only one young magician was allowed into the sacred spring every year, and he hoped that MoFan would win the spot.
Uy! Di lang ka mananaw! Sige, ngunin mo mananaw kag TV eh, cellphone. You're good at singing.
Really?
Thank you.
So he told her that her father was a horrendous piece of trash who deserved to get his butt whipped for bullying his father. He remembered how Joanne had kicked his father after he was caught trying to run away, and had always hoped to make him feel like she would return. As he summoned a flame, he promised to destroy her brother like he was a useless thief. The following day, MoFan arrived at the family home for his duel and came across his team who failed to recognize him. Tai Tang was angered by the sight of him and told him that her brother would wipe the floor with his apple. As he began to leave, the team thought he looked familiar, but Kai Tang told them that Mo Fan was the most moronic loser they could ever hope to meet. A few hours later, Jan Kong met Mo Fan while he was eating a meal and wondered if he was finally willing to join his army. But Mo Fan thought he was still useless and told him to fuck off. Shortly, his friends appeared before him and told him that they had come to cheer him for his fight. But he could care less about their disgusting faces. That evening, with all the guests gathered at the arena, Joanne's son, Yuan, began approaching Mo Fan. As they faced off, Yuan began to freeze Mo Fan.
You're looking smart. Really?
Straight to the hospital. But Mo Fan told him that he would destroy his ugly face and melt it off the ice. As Joanne commanded the duel to begin, Yuan raised his hand and cast creeping ice towards Mo Fan. But he melted it and launched a flame that Yuan narrowly evaded. Desperate to escape, he activated his magical shoes and vanished from another flame before vanishing again. Looking to stop him, Mo Fan fired a powerful blaze, but Yuan jumped away and jumped back before evading more fires and swooshing away. As Mo Fan unleashed another firestorm, Yuan jumped over him, and as he landed, he told him that he was as useless as his ugly face. He began to unleash a level 3 ice storm that turned the arena floor to ice and caused Mo Fan's flames to vanish. At the same time in the arena, principal suggested that they call off the duel before Mo Fan froze to his death. Joanne told him that he wishes to see Mo Fan's ugly face carved in ice. At the same time, Mo Fan's flames continued to vanish, so he decided to awaken the 7 stars of his fire element. And as he summoned a flame, more flames began to surround him and rolled up into a firestorm. As he released the fires,
it stopped. Why? Your hair is.
Mo Fan increased the power.
What is stop?
And as it caught Yuan's shoes, it erupted in a mighty explosion and spread a blinding light across the arena. However, Yuan rose again, but was surprised that
what? It stopped. It's not stopped.